gang rape horror, teens gang rape, chief minister blamed parents. Message from Goa, you are responsible for your own security. Did the Goa chief minister victim shame, or was the Goa chief minister misrepresented? Top story on To The Point this evening.
Good evening, you're watching To The Point. I'm Preeti Chaudhary. As horrific was what happened in Goa the night of 25th of this month, 25th of July, where two young girls, 14 years old, gang raped the two boys that they were with, beaten up by four men. Well, as horrific was also the statement made by the Chief Minister of Goa on the Goa Assembly, where he practically said that they were responsible for their own security and parents should think twice before sending their young girls onto the beach. However, now he's come out and said he was misrepresented.
25th July, Benelim, South Goa. Gang rape of two 14-year-old girls sends shockwaves across country. Outraged citizens, political opposition corners the Goa government. The Goa Chief Minister Pramod Sawant's reaction leaves everyone in shock, enraged. During the assembly debate, the Chief Minister, who also holds the home portfolio, said, when 14-year-olds stay on the beach the whole night, the parents need to introspect. Just because children don't listen, we cannot put the responsibility on the government and police. He also said parents have a duty to ensure their minor children's safety and should not let them stay out late at night.
उसी का डिस्कशन हुआ था और उन्हीं चारों लोगों को अरेस्ट किया है, तुरंत अरेस्ट कर दिया है और उसमें से एक जो गवर्नमेंट सर्वेंट था उसको सस्पेंड कर दिया है। मुझे लगता है लेकिन इट इज द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ द पेरेंट्स ऑल्सो, क्योंकि माइनर बच्चों को बाहर भेजते वक्त उतनी जिम्मेदारी उन लोगों ने भी लेनी चाहिए।
The statement exploded politically in a state poised for elections in the next 6 months. The Chief Minister of Goa victim shaming, parent blaming and shirking law and order responsibility turned into a hot political face-off.
ने सेम ने ऐसा कुछ बोला ही नहीं, कौन बोल रहा है सेम ने ऐसा बोला है? सेम ने अपनी एक भावना व्यक्त की है जो फैमिली मैन है कि माँ बाप को बोला है कि लड़की छोटे छोटे बच्चे लोगों को 3, 3:30 बजे 4 बजे ऐसा मत भेजो.
The Chief Minister is clearly attempting to shift the responsibility of security, law and order, safety from the state to the parents. Chief Minister is sort of indicating or making the victim responsible for the rape when actually it is the police which has not done patrolling, which has failed to apprehend the culprits.
This statement cannot be the justification. आज तक ऐसा नहीं होता था और नहीं होना चाहिए. मुझे लगता है ऐसा आगे भी नहीं होना चाहिए. गवर्नमेंट शुड टेक स्टेप टू सी सच थिंग्स डज नॉट हैपन.
Facing citizen ire and political blowback over what was perceived to be a message to the world that Goa is unsafe and that it's up to the visitors to ensure their own safety, the Chief Minister, with his back to the wall, issued a statement saying he was misrepresented. My statement about the unfortunate incident was taken out of context, both as head of a responsible government and as a father of a 14-year-old daughter. I was deeply pained and disturbed. Pain of this incident is inexplicable. At no point I have tried to deny the right to security provided by our law. Goa Police has been truly a professional force, especially when it comes to security of women and children. So what really happened? On the night of 25th July, 10 teenagers went to a party on the Benelim beach, of which 6 came home. 4 stayed back all night. 2 boys and 2 girls. They were 14-year-old children. 4 men, one a government employee, posed as policemen, and raped the two girls after beating up the boys. All four have since been arrested. While the Goa chief minister over his alleged insensitive comment and his government over abysmal law and order situation in the state are facing intense citizen anger, there has been another rape that has been reported in Goa, making it 3 reported rapes in 1 week alone. An eerie reminder of the dark Goa underbelly that continues to thrive behind the lure of its spectacular beaches. Bureau Report, India Today.
Let's cut across to our panelists this evening. I have Prathima Betsy Cautino. She's the state vice president of the Aam Aadmi Party, which is hoping to give a fight to the BJP the elections in the next 6 months in the state. I have Dr. Geeta Bhatt, academician. I also have Tanisha Sangha. She's the multimedia director of ITGT, and she is living right now in the state of Goa. Tanisha, you know, I want to come to you first because you are in Goa. How has the statement of Mr. Sawant, which he now says was misrepresented, but it was very clear because he made the statement on the floor of the house where he pretty much shifted the onus on the 14-year-old girls and the parents. How has that been perceived by the civil society and the citizenry in Goa?
Well, Preeti, good evening. I would just say that the Goan community is in a state of shock. Something like this is unheard of in Goa. It doesn't have a history of being unsafe for women. And the rapes itself is shocking. But what was even more shocking, which has caused more outrage, is the comment by the CM. And there is a lot of anger over here. People are very angry, not just on social media, but anybody that you speak to. They feel that they have been cheated because they feel that, you know, it's a responsibility of the police and of the government to make sure that they are safe. And the statement has been taken very, very negatively. And I think that there is a lot of outrage and it's not going to die down very quickly.
You know, elections are in order in the state, Tanisha, in the next 6 months. There's a lot of political flux that is on as we speak. Over and above all of that, there have been now 3 rapes, Tanisha, in 1 week alone. There have been at least 3 recorded rapes. 2 of these underage girls, 14-year-old, and 1 which was reported just yesterday, exposing the underbelly of Goa behind, you know, these beautiful sunsets.
Absolutely, absolutely. And in fact, the fact that they were minor girls and the statement was made right after that, I mean, I think it's going to blow up a little bit more than what it is right now. People are feeling the pinch. And also the tourism industry, which Goa is dependent on so heavily, felt that his remarks would kind of negatively impact them because they heavily now are hoping to open up for foreign tourists. And if foreign tourists feel unsafe in India, in Goa, that is going to be a huge problem for Goa as a state.
All right, Tanisha, appreciate you joining us. Thank you. There, I want to cut across right now to Geeta Bhatt. Geeta Bhatt, I'm just reading out, and it's verbatim on what the chief minister said on the floor of the house just a day ago. Of course, he's now said he was misrepresented. Tell me, where's the misrepresentation when the chief minister of a state, madam, says when 14-year-olds stay on the beach the whole night, the parents need to introspect. Just because children don't listen, we cannot put the responsibility on the government and the police. Who takes responsibility? 14-year-old children?
Well, Preeti, first of all, this is really a very, very unfortunate incident. And, you know, 14-year-olds, they are just kids. And going through such a harrowing experience, it must have scarred them mentally and physically. But yes, the law and order definitely is a state subject. And every government is accountable, responsible to the people. In booking such those who are responsible for a crime as per the law of the land. Now, as you just informed, that those who did this heinous crime, they have already been arrested. And at the same time, but the concern, I feel, what the chief minister was trying to convey, maybe they did not come out that way, was basically that every parent who is responsible always has a feeling of, you know, always makes sure, ensures that their children are safe. And especially when at a time when there were COVID restrictions in the state, or there was up to 7 a.m. in the morning, there were restrictions. One was not allowed to be on the beach. In such circumstances, it is very natural that parents will have that concern that where their children are at night. So it was more of a...
Ms. Geeta Bhatt, I don't, you know, Dr. Bhatt, as I bring in Ms. Coutinho, I don't really have children, but I have dealt with nieces who are teenagers. I don't know, if you've dealt with teenagers yourself, because try telling a 14-year-old what she can and cannot do. How can you shift the blame and the onus on the parents? The 14 years don't know better.
Not at
parents,
all.
You can't blame the parents.
I have a daughter and, I have a teenage daughter. And that is how one can relate to this incident. And definitely they do not listen. And that is why that concern, because they are at such a tender age, they get influenced so easily.
So, madam, don't you think the chief minister should have known better instead of making the insensitive statement?
So you see, he has come out and he has clarified, but it is very clear. He said that the parents, they need to introspect that, when the children are out, they should be concerned about.
Madam, I would reckon the chief minister and the state security machinery should introspect. That's what the citizens want. I want to bring in Ms. Coutinho as well. Ms. Coutinho, you have elections in the next 6 months in the state. How much is the political protest political in nature and less about citizenry?
Let me first start by saying that we condemn what has happened and the statements, the barbaric and insensitive statements made by the CM of Goa, the BJP CM, that's Pramod Sawant. It's been very barbaric and insensitive. And the thing is, as you all know, that these four youngsters were on the beach with their friends. They were just having a good time there. They were just strolling around. But then these four men who came and tried to exhibit themselves as cops, and they literally went beating the boys and went and raped the girls. And the Govans were expecting from the CMs to say something to take the responsibility, to take some accountability, because CM is not only this chief minister of Goa, but Pramod Sawant is also the home minister. He should have admitted that the law and order has failed in Goa, and that he has failed big time. And as she was just saying, that as you just said, that CM made the statements. Yes, CM made the statements on the floor of the assembly, saying that the parents need to introspect. And he said that what were the girls doing at the VRs? Well, CM should have said, but what were the boys doing at that hour who have committed such a crime? And why put the buck on the girls and the parents? He should have been consoling. Array, it's like adding salt on the wounds. We Goans are very upset and hurt when BJP government talks about Beti Padhao, Beti Bachao. Here, betis are getting raped, and on the contrary, console karna chahiye. Uske about you, they're adding salt to the wounds, which we feel that we Goans are peace-loving. We never discriminate boys and girls. The whole of the entire world sees Goa as a tourism place. And you have seen in the past how the youngsters want to come to Goa. Maybe couples, the party time or picnic type is Goa. And we were always safe. But today, we feel that under the leadership of Pramod Sawant, the BJP government, the BJP CM, the law and order has collapsed. And
Dr. Geeta Bhatt, CM should have taken some responsibility
and accountability.
Okay. Dr. Geeta Bhatt, would you not reckon, instead of saying I was misrepresented, you can see what he said. You can't be misrepresented in what you have actually said on the floor of the house. He should have apologized and said it was the wrong choice of words.
Well, you see, CM in his own judgment is going to make a statement, as per his understanding. But it is very important also, I would like to also my co-panelists just to remind that when there are, COVID restrictions and there are curfew hours, it is not just for children, but for every citizen, every responsible citizen to ensure that you do not go out of the house. You don't stay out of the house in the, stay
and
out
if you
of
go
the
out, Ms. Geeta, and if you go and out, Dr. Bhatt, you risk getting gangrene.
You see, Preeti, very unfortunate, but the fact remains that, we can hold governments accountable if they do not, if they shy away in doing their duty of punishing the culprits. But those
the very,
who have
madam, the government
society,
needs to be held accountable.
The very
okay, go ahead, Ms. Coutinho, one second.
Yeah. The very that, fact,
you know,
the
but fact, the men the who have committed
that the CM says that what were the girls
okay, okay, you know, no point, no, no point talking over each other.
What were the girls doing?
Dr. Bhatt, I'll come back to you. Dr. Bhatt, Dr. Bhatt, I'm coming right back to you. One second. Let's go one by one. Miss Coutinho, you say what you have.
To the man that girl is out, and you can go and
Miss Coutinho.
Is the Constitution of India saying, is there any fast, hard rules that girls should not be going out?
Okay.
Why be so gender biased? Okay. Where is the right to equality, right to gender, okay. right to safety and security gone? It's a hard-earned money that we pay taxes not to get raped and get the take the blame on the contrary, take the blame.
Okay.
It's like the CNN.
Okay, Ms. Coutinho, you've made your point. You have made your point, Ms. Coutinho. I want to go back to Dr. Geeta Bhatt. Dr. Bhatt, you know, the fact is, by saying that the government has taken responsibility by arresting the accused, that's not the point, madam. Before the accused were arrested, the chief minister came and said that parents need to introspect.
Well, Preetiji, I would also like to remind my co-panelists that in his party there are elected representatives who used to beat their wives. In Delhi, there was an MLA, Mr. Somnath
Don't
Bharti.
Try to dive
now,
into
what can we just go one by one? Can I just get Dr. Geeta Bhatt?
Have the patience to at least know what the MLAs of your parties have been doing.
Geeta Bhatt, I don't think Dr. Bhatt, I don't think you want to go down that road. It's a slippery slope for the BJP.
It's a slippery slope for
most parliamentarians. So let's not go down the road of what's happening in Delhi. Let's stick to what's happening in Goa.
It's slippery slope for all the political parties because
we are talking about Goa and being a Goan.
People who have a misogynist tendency.
We're talking about Goa.
Yes, madam. So therefore, I ask you one second. Therefore, okay. Can I just get Dr. Geeta Bhatt? Dr. Geeta Bhatt. Therefore, the citizens are.
He did not make the comment about the girl.
Okay. Can we all just calm down? Dr. Geeta Bhatt, can you hear me? Dr. Bhatt, I don't think you can hear me. Can you hear me?
Themselves from the cops.
Dr. Bhatt, can you hear me? Can you hear me, Dr. Bhatt?
Yes, I can.
Yeah. The question is, should the chief minister of Goa, as a woman, which you are sitting here, you say you're a parent as well, and importantly as a citizen, I don't think woman has anything much to do with it, should he apologize or not?
See, he has come out and he has, he has put, I cannot speak for that. I'm not a representative of the Goa government, so I cannot speak for him, first of all.
Would you think he should apologize?
But yes, the fact is, the point is that we also need to look at it with a broader perspective the citizens, responsible citizens and the government, they together can make the society safe.
Madam,
it
responsible
cannot be
just citizens.
A one-sided road,
madam.
So the fact is that.
Okay,
that
I need to. Okay, ladies, I need to bow out of this debate. That's all the time that we have for right now. But when we talk about responsible citizens, does it mean that they invite rape if they step out because there's a COVID pandemic and there's a protocol? Do they invite rape because their daughters and their sons are out at night on a beach and they are the ones who should introspect? It is a moment to introspect for the Goa chief minister. Should he not apologize instead of saying he was misrepresented? A quick break. Up next is Rahul Kabal.